Alright everyone, Buzz Killington bringing you another BuzzCast, and as you can see this is a map that's quite unusual that we don't normally cast. It's Barstow Badlands, and because there's so rarely games uploaded I thought I would actually cast it. We have over here on the left as the Red Knot faction, Edward Cookie. This is the second reason, they're new players, I don't know who they are, so we'll see what kind of players they are. And we have Monkey D, or Monkey D here, and we will see that Monkey D is Steel Talons. He's got a watchtower drop, he's building infantry, so he knows what he's doing. And we have Nod Vanilla from what's-his-face over here, Edward. Edward versus the monkey. Cookie versus monkey. And monkey looks like he's going to get this fight. Is he going to get to the bunker in time? Oh, he's not. He's not going to get there in time. He's come off the worst from that. He needs to retreat to his bunkers. They'll be all right there. Edward has an engineer coming. Does monkey have one? He does, but he's pulled it back. That's not necessarily a good idea. It looks like Edward is committing to it. He will take the spike. Now, as you can see, for those not familiar with this map, you have a small field for each player, and then the beautiful flower formation of tip fields around here, which forces you to expand to the center. Does make it all a little bit difficult. Oh, hello. Oh. Somebody's left a little treat here. Wow. So he actually blew up the spike. He blew up the spike rather than let Monkey have it. Now, you might think that was a good idea, but I would not. For the simple reason that it cost Edward 500 to claim the spike in the first place. He then got it back, but then he destroyed it immediately. So he got, what, for all that investment and time, he got like 50 tip out of it at the most. Totally not worth it. He could have held that onto that for a while longer. But in any case, he's gone double refinery without an war factory, which is very interesting from Edward here. He's kept his hand of Nod around, whereas on this side we have a sell-off. We can see that Monkey is a little bit behind, but he has got one harvester, and he's built Pitbull Titan. Okay, it's not going to be a top level game, let's look at it this way. But, oh, you never know, a noob game every so often is good for the blood, said no one ever. Okay, he is starved for funds at the moment, so really he needs to be saving for a second refinery. This guy at least did get his 500 back. He did not get that option. We have an engineer coming across now for some reason. I'm not quite sure why. Because, for the simple reason, there is infantry in this bunker here. So if that's infantry if that engineer crosses over there, he's actually going to die. It's going to die, and that will be a waste of 500. Ah, we have a scout. That's why. We've got a scout coming out. These guys are useless for taking out the infantry in there. I mean, eventually it will die, but... okay, what is going on here? What is he doing? Wow, okay, he's put a booby trap on a section of bridge, which is something I didn't know you could do. Now, that cost him $100 to booby trap a section of bridge. But hang on, nobody's going to walk across that, are they? Oh, it does explode when somebody moves over it. So he's going to destroy the bridge when something goes over it. But okay. Cost him $100 though. Was it really worth it? And in the meantime, we have two pits here. And they're going to kill his harvester. They should kill the harvester. There we go. Nice work. Nice work from Monkey. Oh, and he's trod on another harvester with his Titan. Oh my god. That's absolutely... Edward is being so clever here, and he's just lost two Titans. He's going to lose a Scorp tank. He's lost a Scorp tank too. Titan's going to die now. There really is no saving it. Is it going to trample these infantry? It might get a stomp on. Is it going to get a stomp on? Run, rocket troops. Okay, they made it. But now Edward is in dire straits here. He needs a harvester. He went tier 2. He went tier 2, so he's going to be very low on funds. He needs himself a harvester. Does he have enough funds for it? That is the real question. It looks like he does, but he won't have much left. Second refinery down from Monkey in the meantime. He now has 3 harvesters. He's building pits to replace his losses. This is a good plan. This engineer is still sitting here on the bridge, which is pointless. And Edward does have one harvester back out. So, well, there you go. I mean, Edward had the early advantage, but then he's wasted 500. And he's put a suitcase bomb down here for no particular reason. Because it's just pointless. It's just going to blow a section. It's going to blow a section of the bridge. It won't destroy the whole bridge, I don't think. I've never actually seen it happen before, so I'm not entirely sure. And in the meantime, well, he wants to keep the pressure up because Edward is now rebuilding harvesters. He will have a second on the way now. He sold off one of his refineries because he doesn't really need it. Personally, I would have powered that down and probably kept it around, because once he's built another harvester after this one, he's going to need two refineries, and it's going to cost him $3,000 to replace that. It would have made more sense to keep that around. Okay, we have Mass Pits coming. Mass Pits and a Wolverine coming in. He should have vision of this. The question is he going to be able to do anything about it? We do have rockets here. They will get some damage done. Oh, here's the engineer. For some reason. Okay, I think the rocket's got a shot off at the pitbull. Oh, the engineer dies. Nice. He's pulled his harvesters back. Are the pits going to commit to destroying the harvester? They ideally want to take out the scorp. They can't take out this scorp. Oh, he's dancing them about. He's doing quite well with the maneuvering. Is it going to get away? Oh, no, they're stuck on the wrong side. That's good maneuvering. He's lost the harvester. Is he going to lose a second? I don't think he will. I think this one should survive. The scorp is doing work here. It should succeed in taking them out. This scorp will live. This harvester will live. So that wasn't really a very good trade. He would have been better off killing the scorp first. Would have been a pain with the war factory there, but he could have got it done. Ideally, he should have got his rockets out of the bunker there. So we have one harvester left, although its health isn't good at the moment. What is Edward Monkey going to, Monkey Boy over here going to do? Oh, he's going to go into air off one tip field. That's interesting. I'm not sure how he thinks he's going to be able to sustain that. Tier 2 is powered down at the moment. He needs another power plant before he does anything else. Is he upgrading one? I would hope he would upgrade it because he needs the power. Okay, what are we going for? I would expect an Orca probably. Yeah, he's going Orcas. Hammerheads honestly might have been a better bet there. But, well, Orcas are pretty useful, but he'll need a pit bull in here to scout the harvester. And then it will be pretty useful. Both players need to be thinking about expanding. Okay, we have Titans coming in to clippity-stompy-stomp over the harvesters if they get the opportunity to. Oh, a few shots coming down. Oh, some good shots get happening on that Wolverine. Done half damage to it already. They are getting a few shots off. That is paying for itself. Okay, we have one harvester. What is he going to do? Oh, he's sold this off. He's selling off. Oh, he's selling off everything. He needs the funds here. Pitbulls are coming in too soon. Too soon. They want to pull back there. Is that heroic? Maybe not. No, I don't think so. Right, Titans are stomping in. I'm not quite sure where the Wolverines are. Double Titan coming in. They can take out these Scorps. Oh, they switched targets. They switched targets. That's a terrible idea. What are you doing, dude? You're not going to kill one of them at this rate. Oh, no. Come on. There we go. He's got one. But the other one's been completely repaired now. That was a complete waste of time. Where did the Wolverines go? Lost track. But in any case, the Harvesters are taking advantage in the meantime and moving around here. He is keeping some pressure on. He's built double Scorp. Oh, the Orcas are back in the back of the base. They're targeting the refinery. If they take that refinery out, that's really going to be it. I mean, if he was going to do that, it probably would have been better if the Titans had fired a few shots on the refinery. They could have taken it out, I think. But in the meantime, at least, we had collection of tip going on from the center. This one is still harvesting nothing. Oh, hello, a flame tank. Oh, my God. A sneaky flame tank. I didn't even see this. Sneaky flame tank round the back of the base. Is it going to kill him in time? It might take out the war factory. It's actually going to take out the war factory. Oh my God, did he sell off his construction? He sold it off or he lost it, and he's lost his war factory. And this is actually it. Edward has actually won the game. That sneaky flame tank has done work. He has a war factory left. He is going to be all right here, unless he loses that refinery. Okay, they've got no choice now. They've really got to try and take out this refinery. The problem is now they have Orcas that they can't refuel. He doesn't have any units. Unless his MCV is expanded. He's lost his MCV. Those pitbulls need to get in there and destroy that refinery. Are they going to get it? They've got it. The pitbulls have killed it. But now that's probably it for him though. Because they don't have any units left. Don't have any troops left. The pits need to get out of there. There's only two left. And once these die, that's it. Because now we have an MCV. Is he going to have the funds to rebuild a refinery? I mean, it doesn't really matter. Yeah. Oh, there we are. He's given up. Well, what can you say about that game? It was very back and forth, not the highest quality, but did have a few twists. Not the highest scoring game. Monkey, unsurprisingly, had the best resources. Edward, that sneaky flame tank absolutely suited Bacon. Monkey kept the pressure up, but he didn't prioritize his targets. And as for Edward messing about with the engineer, putting the suitcase bomb on the bridge, nobody even went over the bridge. Complete waste of his time. But yeah, what can you say, really? I mean, it was an interesting game. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Not too long. Keep uploading some replays. I know, Phantom, you have sent me a couple, but I'm going to have to try and find the maps to download them so I can actually... It's Ray Mama's Guns or whatever the hell it is. I will try and find those maps for you, but this is a quick and easy little game to cast, so I thought I would do that. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll catch you next time for another BuzzCast.